This is a true story of four strangers.
Picked to live in a house, work together, and have their lives taped.
To find out what happens when people stop being polite.
Mm-hmm. Hold on. And start getting real.
The Real World DPT!
Woo!
Wow. Julie last night.
Have you seen her this morning?
No, is she alive?
I don't know, I haven't seen her since the cab.
Oh my god.
Good morning.
It's so bright in here right now, guys.
Here, I think you need that more than I do.
We literally had to do a two-man transfer on you last night out of the cab.
God. I don't even remember that.
It was bad.
Those lesbian midgets just kept bringing us shots. What was that all about?
I don't know. Those little babies, I just love them.
I know. This is the last time you guys need to go to the nursing home for bingo night.
Grandma gone wild.
We got a new task today.
Oh, wow.
Well, it says, for today's task, we'll be focusing on the abilities of DPTs to work together. DPTs in all fields know the importance of teamwork to provide adequate care for the patient. During this task, you will need to pull together and formulate the treatment plan for a patient at New Hope Rehabilitation Center at South Boise. Though each of you have your very own philosophy of care, you need to overcome differences to treat your patient. Meet at South Boise Rehab Center at 8 a.m. to begin your day. Good luck and don't be late.
I'm so annoyed. I cannot work with Allison today. I'm so over all her research. Like, she's always interrupting me. Like, don't interrupt. Rude.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Hi, I'm Barbie.
Nice to meet you, Barbie.
Allison,
nice to meet you. And who are you?
Sam.
Okay, nice to meet you, Sam.
Hi, Julie.
Julie, nice to meet you. Well, welcome to New Hope Rehab Center. We're very privileged that you're here today. We have a lot of things for you to look at, a lot of patients to deal with. Now, after saying that, I have to say that we will not handle any more shenanigans there won't be any shenanigans going on over here, like there was over at that your other place. What was it called? The East Compton Rehab Hut and Smoothie Bar, where I think it was 2 weeks ago, Sam upchucked banana kiwi icy on the hydroculator. Well, that's not going to happen.
It's not my fault. Julie was spinning me around on a pivot board, and I have an inner ear problem, and she knows it, too.
I was not.
Hush, Vertigo.
Okay, well.
Who would have thought I'd have so much fun with one of these things?
Okay, well, I'm sure, but this is a place of business. We want the patients to feel comfortable, and we don't want them to without the fear of, vomit on their hot packs. Is that okay with you guys?
Hey, Mom. I'm having a horrible time here. I try to give people the benefit of the doubt, but I think Julie really doesn't like me.
I just really don't like Sam.
Okay. Hi, Mrs. Brown. My name's Barbie. I'm going to be your physical therapist today.
Nice to meet you.
Okay, well, I was thinking we could start out with some exercises to get you warmed up.
Oh,
so if you want to go ahead.
Pack.
I like to start with beverages and snacks.
Wait a minute. We need to ask a few questions.
Don't interrupt. Rude.
Okay, I'm going to start with just a few questions. Are you comfortable sitting there while we talk?
Yeah.
Okay. So what brings you to the clinic today?
Well, I've had a little pain in my back.
Okay. Can you show me where the pain is?
Right about here.
Okay. And how long have you had the pain?
About 2 weeks.
Okay. And does it feel like the pain moves at all, or is it...
No.
Okay.
Enough questions. We're going to start what I like to call therapy, okay?
So now would be a good time to question whether or not Barbie actually knows anything about the clinical prediction rule.
I think she does.
Okay, Mrs. Brown, what we're going to do is I'm going to have you stand up and we're going to do a little therapy.
Just stay seated for just a moment. Catherine, can I see you for just a second?
You better be here to apologize.
No. I was just wondering why you're in such a hurry to start the motion testing on her.
Well, Allie, I wanted to get her up and moving so I could observe her defects so we can get started on treatment and get her out of here faster.
That sounds lovely.
Lovely? Really?
I'd really like to find a little bit more information on her to see if I can help categorize her into a condition.
Okay, how do you come up with these categories?
Well, if we determine if she meets the criteria for the clinical prediction rule, our likelihood of success will increase.
Clinical prediction rule, likelihood for success. What is this? I'm a therapist.
Today was so much harder than it needed to be. If Barbie knew a little bit about the clinical prediction rule, things would have gone so smooth. Flynn did a study with patients who had low back pain, and if they met these five simple questions, he knew manipulation was the way to go. He had a fantastic success rate. Starts with this little fear of avoidance belief questionnaire. You take this little quiz, they score it, and if it's less than 19 points on this scale, they've met one of the criteria. What was hers?
It says she has 16.
There's one. If the symptoms are less than 16 days, I believe hers was, 2 weeks?
2 weeks, yes.
There's two. Symptoms not extending distal to the knee.
Oh yeah, I think she might have had pain in her hips, but that's it.
There you go. More than 35 degrees of hip internal rotation.
I remember, she got 38.
There you go. And more than one hypomobile segments in the lumbar region. I think she had two.
Yeah.
There you go. She has met all five criteria.
So what does that mean?
Manipulation is the way to go. It's the smartest treatment to give her. And we'd be done.
Awesome.
How can you expect me to believe that categorizing a patient will increase their likelihood for success?
Since our patient met five of the criteria, we know that it's a shoo-in to go this way. If she had only met two of those particular questions, the success rate would have only been 9%. But because she met more than four or more, the success rate went up to 97%, which increases her chances of success for the short term and the long term.
Wow.
Hey, you two, we're done with the exam. Thanks for joining us.
What'd you find?
Well, Sam here found hypermobility on L3 and L4 segments. Mm-hmm. I also found 38 degrees of internal rotation on both legs.
Yeah, you guys, we're ready for some interventions.
Oh, it's setting into this pattern where the two of them go off and bicker, and I'm waiting for Barbie to actually smack her upside the head, and I'm stuck with Captain Vertigo over here trying to do some kind of treatment, and the whole time I'm wondering if he's going to, maybe not, throw up on the patient.
Does that feel okay?
Oh, yeah, much better. Much better.
Great job on your manipulation, Castle. Let's do some active range of motion.
No, you say it.
I want to say it.
I said it last time.
You're such a baby. We'll do it together.
Okay.
Ready?
Next time on the real world.
All right, Sam, are you ready? I swear this is gonna fix your inner ear problem.
Well, if you're sure.
Oh, I'm sure. My tummy's turning and I'm feeling kind of homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. That's when the taxi man turned on the radio and a Jay-Z song was on. And a Jay-Z song was on. And a Jay-Z song was on.
Everybody's looking at me now. I ruined it.
What?
Nothing.
We were on a roll.
Well, the warm up leads into the joke of the hot pack.
Hold on. And start. Hold on. And start.
This is not funny.
That's a wrap.